advice that we would give 360-degree storytellers is don't be afraid to make mistakes. There was this one particular bluff when we were starting out that we went to that particular bluff 6 different times in order to shoot that story, because each different time something went wrong. We either had a setting wrong, we left a lens cap on, or one of the cameras fired a still photo instead of a video shot. So after those 6 different times, we learned after each mistake, not to repeat that again. So don't be afraid to fail. Take risks. Go to that shot as many times as it is needed in order to figure out how to capture those stories in 360 degrees.
The advice I give to storytellers who are interested in working in VR and just beginning is that they should experiment. Try anything new that they can think of. Break all the rules. In fact, there are no rules, so you don't even have to worry about breaking them. But do what you think is crazy and what you think is probably not going to work and seems outrageous, and see what works, because you'll probably be surprised about, you'll be surprised how different this medium is. And we have to experiment in order to figure out how to use it.
I always get a question in terms of how do I start and how much it costs. You can always go in the low end with the Ricoh Theta, and there's a new camera from Samsung, the Samsung Gear 360, and I just saw one called the Insta 360 Nano. There will always be cheaper equipment. Great. Get your hands on one of those and just start playing with it, putting it in certain areas that justify looking around. Not only just on a tripod, but put it in situations. Hang it over the side of a building. Put it on a drone. Put it on a balloon and see what happens. Try to play with this new form factor and see what that is. Playing, for me, is with purpose. Experimentation will bring you to a better set of storytelling techniques. So you have to get in now. You have to start experimenting now. And in doing so, it'll prepare you from right when the perfect story comes along. You know how to use the techniques and lessons that you've learned before and apply them now.
I think the one piece of advice that I would give to anybody just beginning in this medium is lock the camera off. If you need people to be in different parts of a scene, create the content, or if you're filming in 360, or put the camera of the viewer in a locked position and then move it to another position. If the user can't walk themselves, you risk the possibility of them getting nauseous, because essentially, when you've got a camera that's moving, your eyes are saying you're moving, but your body's saying you're sitting still. And that disconnect is what causes what we call sim sickness or simulation sickness. So the best advice that I could ever offer is, very first and foremost, lock the camera off first, and then later on you can begin to experiment with any kind of movement.
My advice to people that are just entering into VR storytelling is, don't reinvent the wheel. Storytelling is storytelling, and people want to see engaging stories. So use voiceover, use the techniques that you would typically use to create and tell a story, and you'll find that, hey, VR is not really different, it's just you have a bigger palette. Instead of creating for a frame, you're creating all around you. So enjoy that, have fun with it. This is not manual labor, it's virtual reality. It's supposed to be fun.